is one of the most important small car market in the world. And in that segment, the small sedan, which is in India called as a mid-size sedan, is a very key player. Hyundai is offering the latest model to that segment, the new Hyundai Aura. It's based on the latest Grand I-10 Nios. And we having the first drive of the new Aura in indoor. Welcome to Flywheel. Here is the all new Hyundai Aura. As I said, the Aura is based on Grand I-10 Nios, and the major difference is from the rear, or from the C-pillar, is a boat has been added on to the design, and it's been incorporated well. And to add flavor and to get that sporty feel, they have blacked out the C-pillar, which is again a lavatory-rated kind of a design. And there is a roof line, which is a kind of a coupe-like round roof line. The body lines are giving a masculine feel, character for a sporty feel. And when you come to the front end, there is a bit of difference from Grand I-10 Nios, which is on the grille. The Cascadia grille has been retained. Actually, it's actually shortened in the height, because on Nios is a bigger grille, but on this Aura, it's a broader one. And the lower part of the grille has been dominated by the air vent from the bumper. And the other difference is the double boomerang daytime running light on Aura, where in Nios is a single one. But rest of the thing, headlight, bumper, everything remains the same as in the Nios. When you come to the rear end, you can see a very different design philosophy, which we have not seen in any other car in Indian Hyundai stable. It's a different treatment gone on to the taillight. It's a C-like treatment, which is connected with the chrome strip over here. The big Aura logo has been brought in, and the boot remain without the registration plate. It's been shifted onto the bumper. It gives a very wide smile kind of a feel when you look straight from the rear. So this is a design treatment which gone on to the new Aura, which is not actually very similar to what we have seen in other sedan models of Hyundai in India. It's a difference which will take little time to accept for some people. Hyundai given a two-wheel options in India. One is the 15-inch alloy, another one is the 15-inch steel rim. The steel rim is attractive with a good design, and the alloy design is again the diamond cut alloy, which give a very attractive feel for this design. Most attractive element of Hyundai's recent interiors are build quality, fit and finish, and practical design. We have seen that from Verna to Creta, and even for the sibling Nios. That has been carried on to Aura as well. It's a very practical, well ergonomically designed interior with a very good fit and finish. And the design also is very impressive. Hyundai is known for crafting one of the best interior in its segments. Made maybe build quality, material finish or the ergonomics, it really stands out among the rivals. In the new Aura, there are some features which are first of its segment. The new Aura is having an 8-inch infotainment system with a touch screen which can connect with CarPlay and Android Auto. Steering is a multifunction with all the controls mounted on your steering wheel. Wireless charging pad is also available with the new Aura. The semi-digital instrument control with multifunction information system is very useful for the driver. Aura also comes with a keyless entry. Those options get a button start for the engine. All the Hyundai models are fitted with the latest AC system, which actually ionizes the air and purifies it to the cabin, which really gives a refreshing experience in the car. Welcome to the other driving aspects of the new Aura. One thing I have to mention is the suspension. Hyundai is known for making one of the best suspension for Indian cars, and it's same with the Aura. You can really feel a very good suspension system even on this bad patch of road. You may feel a bit of shake coming on the camera because we are not going on a smooth road, but suspension is playing a very good role. It's not actually having any damp or disturbing or killing any kind of comfort. Having said that, Hyundai also consider the NVH level of the car. Hyundai were able to maintain the NVH in a very good manner. It's in a very low stage. There's no much wind noise or road noise coming into the cabin. Being the petrol which you are driving, engine noise is also minimum. Even on the diesel, we won't feel much engine noise coming into the cabin. Steering is also a very responsive one. It's a bit of hard one, but we are getting good confidence on driving when you're even pushing in the car on a turn. This steering is playing a very good role. Braking is one area where Hyundai cars normally take a step behind. But with Aura, I think they have taken the right step along with their rivals. Hyundai is offering the new Aura with three engine options, the latest of which is a 1-liter turbo petrol with an output of 110 PS and 170 Nm of torque.
This new petrol engine is only coming with a 5-speed manual gearbox. Other one is a 1.2 liter car-powered petrol engine with an output of 83 PS and 114 Nm of torque. It is mated with 5-speed manual and 5-speed electric AMT gearbox. 1.2 liter EcoTorque is a new BS6 diesel engine which offers 75 PS of power and 190 Nm of torque. This diesel is also fitted with 5-speed manual and an option of 5-speed AMT gearbox. Hyundai also offer a CNG version on 1.2 petrol with an output of 65 PS of power and 95 Nm of torque. All this powertrain is a balance of power and economy. Petrol is claimed to have 20.35 km per litre and the diesel is claimed to be having 25.3 km per litre as ARAI certified fuel efficiency. With around 4 engine options, there are 12 different trims available with the new Aura. Starting price of 5.8 lakhs to 9.03 lakhs ex-showroom, all in their price.
As per the Hyundai claim, they have a better feature list compared to the rivals, which along with Hyundai's build quality and amazing service package, makes the Aura one of the best value for money vehicle in the segment.